Hi friends, today we are going to discuss location of the center of mass in case of objects or bodies having continuous mass distribution. That means their mass is not lies at a point, it is not the point object. Their mass is distributed through certain distance. Such type of objects are called an extended object. Okay, so here first, the center of mass of the wire in the form of an arc whose mass is extended from this end to this end. That's why it is the extended object. So here, in case of extended object, of course, in case of circular arc, which subtends an angle theta at the center. So this arc subtends an angle or makes an angle theta at the center, center of the arc, that is a theta. Here, you imagine this arc-shaped wire symmetrically about y-axis, as in the diagram. You imagine this arc is symmetric about the y-axis. Okay, here it is the x-axis, of course. As it is symmetric and its mass is uniformly distributed along its arc, along the length of the arc, definitely the center of mass lies on the symmetric line. Here, this is the line of symmetry, you know, because about this axis, here this arc is distributed uniformly this side and this side through an angle theta by 2. That's why the center of mass lies at the center of symmetry, means no doubt at the lies on the this symmetrical line. That's why the center of mass of this arc lies on the y-axis but not along x-axis. That's why center of mass may lie somewhere here. This is the location of center of mass. So what is the distance of center of mass from the center of the wire? So we have to identify this one. So this is the YCM. That means here along y-axis, the center of mass of the arc, center of mass of the circular arc is at a distance YCM. We have to derive the formula for this. Along x-axis, if the center of mass, as center of mass lies on y-axis, x coordinate of center of mass becomes 0. It is the case whenever arc is symmetric about the y-axis. If arc is symmetric about the x-axis, then center of mass lies on x-axis only. Y-coordinate of center of mass is 0 in that case. Of course, for our convenience here, I have taken the this arc which is symmetric about the y-axis. Okay? Here, in order to look at the center of mass here, first you imagine small element having length dl. Small element having length dl, which subtends an angle d alpha, because this element is at here, the line joining the two ends of the element and center makes an angle say d alpha. The element is at an angle alpha from vertical or from y axis. Okay, now length here, angle subtended by arc at the center, that means d alpha is equal to, we can write length of the arc by radius. Radius of this arc, that is say capital R. So capital R. From this length of the element, dl is equal to r into d alpha, we can write, no? This is equation 1. Okay, now here mass of this element is say dm. Mass of the element is dm. Okay, then here as center of the circular arc, center of this arc is imagined at the origin, then from the origin, at what distance center of mass of the wire lies along y-axis? That's why you imagine this arc is composed of so many number of this type of elements. Of course, in order to see the element here, I have drawn with more length. But infinite such elements can be imagined from this end to this end. Infinite number of such elements can be imagined from end A to end B. Okay, so for one element here, you know mass of this element say dl. Okay, then along y-axis, what is the distance of this element you find? Okay, suppose from this element here, you draw a perpendicular line onto y-axis. You draw a perpendicular line onto the y-axis. Then the distance of this element along x-axis from the origin, that is equal to say y. So it is the it is the distance of this element along y-axis. Mass of the element is this one. Then what is the formula for y coordinate of center of mass actually? Y coordinate of center of mass. Of course, here xm is equal to 0. As the center of mass lies on y axis, the x coordinate of center of mass is equal to definitely 0.
as this wire is symmetric about y axis. Okay, so y coordinate of Sandrahas is equal to general formula. You will get mass of the, suppose in the system there are number of particles, then m1y1 plus m2y2 plus m3y3, like that we can write by total mass m1 plus m2 plus m3. It is the case of the system consists of number of particles, but here it is a continuous body, mass is distributed continuously. In this case, the same formula can be written as, instead of mass of the particle here, you imagine number of elements from A to B. Here one element is there, their mass is dm and y coordinate is y. Suppose you consider one element here, their mass is again dm1, something like that. You imagine dm into y coordinate, something we can find. In this way, for infinite number of elements we had to find and we had to add like this, but practically it is not possible. That's why for one element you write mass of the element dm into distance of that element along y axis from the origin or from the center of the arc, that is equal to say y. In this way, from A to B, as infinite number of elements are there, from we had to write this infinite number of terms like this and add, we had to add them. So instead of doing so, for one element you write this product of mass and the distance of the that mass of the element along y axis, and then you do integration. Between what limits we have to do integration? Between which limits we can imagine this type of elements here? That means from A to B. A to B means as theta here, alpha is taken from the y axis. This type of elements can imagine from here minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. That's why between alpha is equal to minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. We can imagine by mass of one element is dm. So total mass of all elements means integral dm. So limits alpha is equal to minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. In this way you do. So this is equal to how we can write the mass of the element. Theta by 2 minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. Mass of the element means, suppose the mass per unit length of this arc is say m. Suppose if you are given the length of the arc and mass of the arc. Mass per unit length means linear mass density. Suppose the linear mass density, that means mass per unit length, linear mass density is say lambda. As the mass is distributed uniformly entire its length, so linear mass density is equal to say lambda. Then linear mass density means mass per unit length, that is lambda. Then what is the mass per this much length means? We can write lambda into length of the element, no? Lambda into length of the element, that is the mass of the element, into y. By here also, lambda into dl. Limit say alpha is equal to minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. Here therefore ycm is equal to integral lambda into dl, means we can write r into d alpha. So lambda into dl means r into d alpha into y. What about y? In this right angle triangle, you take sine alpha. Sine alpha is equal to adjacent means y. By hypotenuse means this length is equal to radius, no? So here from the diagram, sine alpha is equal to y by r. So in this right angle triangle, sine alpha is equal to y. Sorry, you take cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to y by r. Sine alpha means opposite by hypotenuse, no? So you take cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to y by r. Cos alpha is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Y by r. So here y means we can write r cos alpha, no? So r cos alpha. Okay, limits same. Alpha is equal to same limits by integral. Here lambda into dl means we can write r into d alpha. So ycm is equal to, here lambda is constant, you can write outside. So integral lambda is constant, you can write outside, into r into r, that is also constant. Wherever you consider the element, the radius of the arc does not change, no? That's why r is constant. Here r into r, r square is there, you write lambda r square. Into cos alpha d alpha. Limits alpha is equal to minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. By here lambda r is constant, you write outside lambda r into integral d alpha limits alpha is equal to minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. Okay, this is equal to lambda r cancel. Okay, then remaining is that is equal to r into integral cos alpha d alpha means sin alpha limits minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2 by integral d alpha means alpha limits minus theta by 2 to plus theta by 2. Okay, therefore YCM is equal to when you substitute the limits r into first upper limit sin theta by 2 sin theta by 2 before substitute lower limit you put minus sign sin of minus theta by 2. Instead of alpha you write minus theta by 2 sin of minus theta by 2 minus theta by 2 whole by here theta by 2 minus of minus theta by 2. So YCM is equal to here sin theta by 2 plus sin theta by 2, that means 2 sin theta by 2 you get now 2 sin theta by 2 by it is theta 2 sin theta by 2 by theta. So this is the r is there now, sorry here r is there, so 2r 2r into sin theta by 2 by theta 2r 2r into sin theta by 2 by theta. So where theta must be in radian, theta must be in radian, theta must be in radian. So x coordinate of center of mass is zero if the diagram is like this. Okay, here this is the location of the center of mass. The distance of center of mass from the origin or from the center of the arc is at a distance 2r sin theta by 2 by theta. Okay, that is the distance of the center mass from the center of the arc. Next, for semicircular arc, for quadrant of the circle, where the center mass lies. Now we have to discuss. Okay. Second one, center of mass of the wire, which is bent in the form of semicircular arc, having uniform mass distribution. Okay. Already in case of arc, distance of central mass along y-axis when arc is symmetric about y-axis is equal to just now we derived 2r sin theta by 2 by theta we derived. But here this is also arc only, but angle subtended by the semicircular arc at the center is this angle. Now that angle is theta is equal to pi. Now here in case of semicircular arc, the angle subtended by arc at the center is equal to theta is equal to pi radian. So you substitute this value here. Therefore, YCM is equal to 2R sin theta by 2. Theta means pi. Pi by 2. Pi by 2 by theta pi. Therefore, YCM is equal to 2R by pi. It is the distance of center mass of the semicircular arc from the center of the semicircular arc. Or, okay, semicircular ring. Or semicircular arc. 2R by pi. R will be given. So 2r by pi, if you write, then that is the distance of center mass of the semicircular ring from the center. Okay, suppose if it is a quadrant of the circle, here the semicircular arc also symmetric about the y-axis. Okay, now third one, suppose there is a quadrant of circle, okay, center of mass of y in the form of quadrant of circle, or 1/4 of the circle. Suppose the given wire is bent in the form of quadrant of the circle. In such case, suppose here it is x-axis, it is y-axis. Here the wire is bent in the form of a quadrant of circle like this. So AB is the quadrant of the circle of radius r. Here this distance is equal to r, or this distance is equal to r. It is the origin or center of the quadrant of the circle. Okay. Now definitely we derived the distance of the center mass of the any arc from the center of the circle, center of the arc, is at a distance 2r sin theta by 2 by theta, where theta is the angle subtended by arc at the center. Here angle subtended by arc at the center is equal to 90. No? So here theta is equal to 90. Theta is equal to 90 degree or pi by 2 radians. Okay. Here this is the formula for distance of the central mass from the center of the earth. Whenever earth is symmetric about y axis. Suppose you imagine the symmetric axis here. You imagine the symmetric axis. This is the symmetric axis. That means angular bisector. It is the angular bisector of this quadrant of the circle. So the total angle is 90. Total angle is 90 means theta is equal to pi by 2. Definitely center mass lies on axis of symmetry or on symmetric line for this quadrant of the circle. That's why center mass lies at this point. Say. It is the position of the center of mass. Suppose the center mass is at a distance, say, from the center of the earth. The center mass is at a distance, say, RCM. So what is the formula for RCM? About the symmetric line from the center, the distance of central mass is RCM is equal to, already this is only formula. So RCM is equal to 2R sine theta by 2 by theta. So R is the radius of the quadrant of the circle that is given R only. So 2R into sine theta means pi by 2 by 2 whole by pi by 2. You write this 2 in the numerator. Then 4R by pi into sine 45. Sine 45 means we can write 1 by root 2. So 4 by root 2 means we can write 2 root 2. 2 root 2 R by pi. This is the RCM value. It is the RCM value. Okay. Therefore, here they asked what are the coordinates of central mass. They asked coordinate of central mass means XCM comma YCM. That means at what distance this point, this central mass of the quadrant of the circle lies along x-axis means this is the distance of central mass from the center on symmetric line. So what is the distance of the central mass of the quadrant of the circle along x-axis means you draw a perpendicular line onto x-axis, from this draw a perpendicular line onto y-axis. So this distance is equal to XCM, this distance is equal to YCM. That means as it is the symmetric line, definitely this angle is equal to 45. So this angle is also equal to 45. Okay, now the component of this RCM along x-axis is XCM. Therefore, XCM is equal to RCM into cos 45, we can write. RCM means 2 root 2 R by pi into cos 45, 1 by root 2. Root 2 cancel. Therefore, XCM is equal to 2 R by pi. R by pi. Similarly, YCM is also R cos 45 you can write or R sin 45 you can write. Suppose if it is only 45 degree, then this is cos 45, this is R sin 45. RCM sin 45. RCM sin 45 means as sin 45 is same, you will get YCM also same. So YCM is equal to 2 R by 5. These are the X coordinate and Y coordinate of the center of mass. But distance of center of mass from this is same. As you know, the X coordinate and Y coordinate, the resultant of these two means the distance of central mass from the center of the quadrant of the circle is square root of this one. Square root of this square plus this square means 2R by pi root 2. You will get 2R by pi root 2. That is the only answer. Okay. 2R by pi root 2. So you will get again RCM. These are the coordinates of the center of mass. In this way, we can find the coordinates of the center of mass if it is located like this. First, whatever the position of the given arc, you imagine the symmetric line about the on the symmetric line at what distance central mass lies means this is the general formula. Find first you find. Then the components along x-axis, along y-axis you find. They are the x and y coordinates of the center of mass. You can find. Okay, this way we have to do. Here, next one. In case of semicircular disk, we have to semicircular disk. In case of circular disk, central mass lies exactly at the geometric center means at the center of the semicircular disk, central mass lies. If it is having uniform mass distribution. In case of semicircular disk, where the central mass lies? You imagine the semicircular disk here. It is the semicircular disk whose radius, suppose the center of the semicircular disk is say this one. It is y-axis. It is say x-axis. So semicircular disk is symmetric about y-axis. Okay, we taken like that. No doubt, as it is symmetric, central mass lies on y-axis somewhere else. Okay, so here, in order to identify the, in order to locate the central mass of the semicircular disk, here, suppose the radius of the semicircular disk, that is Kepler. Radius of the semicircular disk is Kepler. Okay, now we can imagine the semicircular disk as a combination of number of semicircular arcs. No? You imagine one semicircular arc like this. Here, this is the semicircular arc. You imagine one element in the form of a semicircular arc like this. So we can imagine this disk as the combination of number of this type of semicircular elements. No? Suppose in this way, number of semicircular elements are arranged like this. Then it becomes a disk. That's why semicircular disk can be imagined as the combination of number of this type of semicircular rings, semicircular arcs. Okay. Suppose the radius of the semicircular arc. Semicircular arc, that is a smaller, and thickness is say dr. Thickness is dr. Okay, now in case of the semicircular ring or semicircular arc, where the center mass lies, means suppose the center mass lies here, say for this semicircular ring, not due to for this entire disk, for this semicircular arc, center mass lies here, say that is at a distance say y from the center of the semicircular arc or from the center of the disk. Mass of this semicircular element is say dr. Actually, as it is the semicircular disk, the mass is distributed uniformly entire its surface area. Yeah, here the mass of the semicircular disk is uniformly distributed on its area, semicircular area. That's why the surface density, means mass per unit area, surface density of the semicircular disk, surface density is equal to sigma, that is mass by area. Mass by area. Suppose the mass of the entire disk is m. Area of the surface area of this disk is equal to pi r square by 2 only, no? Because it is not the circle, half of the circle only. That's why pi r square. M by pi r square is the surface density. Here surface density, it is having uniform mass distribution. That's why surface density is same throughout its surface. Okay. Suppose that surface density is say sigma. Okay. Now, what is the mass of this element? Because y is equal to what is where the center mass of this semicircular element lies? Center mass of semicircular element lies at a distance 2r by pi. No, if the radius of the semicircular element is r, then it lies at a distance already. In case of semicircular ring, where the center mass lies along y-axis means already just to be derived 2r by pi. No, 2 into r means here it is not Kepler. Here that is r is the in that formula r is the radius of the semicircular ring or semicircular arc. Here radius of the semicircular arc is small by pi. This is the distance of central mass of the semicircular arc. According to the fundamental definition of the semicircular center of mass, the mass of the semicircular arc lies at the central mass. So that is a dm. Of course, mass of semicircular ring is dm, that can be imagined at the position of central mass. So in this way, here from the center, we can imagine number of this type of semicircular elements like this. From y is equal to 0 to r small r is equal to 0 to Kepler. We can imagine number of. Okay, now, therefore, distance of central mass from the center of the disk along y-axis. Because it is symmetric about y-axis, that's why it has x-coordinate 0. So only y-coordinate is there. YCM is equal to. YCM means that is the distance of center of mass from center of disk. Center of disk along y-axis or line of symmetry. YCM is equal to first here for one circular element, just YCM is equal to m1y1 plus m2y2 like that. No, m1 means mass of one element dm into y1 means the distance of that mass, that means their center mass from the center, means that is equal to y. Plus another element. In this way, infinite number of elements we can write like this, and you add them. Instead of doing so, for one element you write like this, and you do the integration between the limits. From which point to which point this type of elements can be imagined, means from small r is equal to capital. Of course, which limits we have to substitute later, we can see. Why? Based on the parameter with respect to which integration is to be done. Based on that, we have to write the limits. Next, integral m1 plus m2 plus m3 means we can write simply dm. So, what is the mass of the element? Here we see mass per unit area is sigma. Therefore, what is the mass of the element? Where dm is equal to? You see, mass for unit area is this one. Then what is the area? Mass is equal to sigma into area. No, sigma into area of this element, surface area of this element. Here, what is the length of this element? That is equal to pi r. No, pi smaller because the radius of this element is smaller. That's why pi r is the length of this semicircular element. Width is dr. Then surface area of this element means the shared part of the area of the shared part. That is the surface area of the element. That's why pi r into length of this semicircular element is pi r into dr. This is the mass of the semicircular element. You substitute there. So from YCM is equal to integral dm. Dm is sigma into pi r dr. Sigma into pi r dr. That is for dm into y. Y means 2r by pi. No? Y means 2r by pi. Whole by integral dm. Dm is sigma into pi r into dr. Sigma into pi r into dr. Okay. Here sigma pi can be written outside. Of course, here pi cancel. Pi cancel. You write 2 outside. You write of course 2 outside, sigma outside. So 2 sigma by pi sigma can be written outside because r is variable. When you consider number of this type of elements, radius of different elements are different. That's why r is variable. 2 sigma by pi sigma you write outside. Integral here. 2 sigma is taken outside, then r into r square, r square dr by integral r dr. As we are doing integration with respect to r limits, we have to substitute small r limits. Here this type of elements can be imagined from small r is equal to 0 to small r is equal to capital r. That's why between small r is equal to 0 to capital r you integrate 0 to capital r is equal to 0 to capital r. So sigma sign will cancel. 2 by pi into here integral r square dr means r cube by 3 we can write limits 0 to capital r by here r square by 2. Integral r dr means r square by 2 limits 0 to capital r. So this is equal to 2 by pi into here capital r cube by 3 of course minus 0 by capital r square by 2 means into 2. When you substitute lower limit it becomes 0. You will get this one. So r square cube cancel. Therefore, YCM is equal to 2 to 4. 4 r by 3 pi. No? 4 r by 3 pi. This is the centra mass of the semicircular disk from the disk. 4 r by 3. That means along y-axis, the centra mass of this entire disk is at a distance of 4 r by 3 pi from the center. So that is the centra mass of the semicircular disk. This is YCM. Okay. This is the answer. Next, in case of hemispherical shell, where the centra mass lies? No doubt here, hemispherical shell is also taken, which is symmetric about the y-axis. That's why definitely centra mass lies on y-axis only. So x coordinate here also zero. Okay, now. In order to locate the centra mass of the hemispherical shell, this hemispherical shell can be imagined as a combination of number of circular rings. No, suppose you cut the slice like this, you cut the slice like this two times, you cut like this, then you imagine one part, then that is in the form of a ring. No, that's why hemispherical shell can be imagined as the combination of number of circular rings like this. One such circular ring or circular element we considered having mass of the element is say dm and width of the element is called dr, radius of that element is say r. Here the way the circular element is considered, that element, the edges of the elements, the edges of this element are joined to center, subtends an angle d theta at the center, and the angle subtended by this element here, circular element, with y axis, that is say theta. That means at an angle theta we consider this circular element. In case of circular element, or it is in the form of a circular ring, centra mass of the circular element is lies at the center only. Centra mass of the circular element or circular ring lies at the center of the ring only. That means at this point only. That's why for this circular element, centra mass lies at a distance say y, which is equal to suppose this is equal to say at a distance y. Okay, of course that y is equal to r cos theta. We can write now from the diagram. You see from the diagram. In this right angle triangle, in this right angle triangle, cos theta is equal to y by r. R cos theta is equal to y by r. Y is equal to r cos theta. So from the diagram, y is equal to r cos theta. Okay. Next here, the mass of the semispherical shell distributed uniformly over its surface only. That's why this is also having surface density. So surface density of the hemispherical shell, surface density of hemispherical shell of shell is equal to say sigma. That means mass per unit area, mass by area, mass by area, mass per unit area is called surface density of the hemispherical shell. What is the mass of this element? Mass of that element means dm is equal to, you see from this formula, mass of the element is equal to sigma into area. We can write now sigma into surface area of the element dsa. Sigma into, what is the surface area of the element? Here we consider the circular element having radius r, means length of the circular element is equal to 2 pi r. Length is 2 pi r and width is dr. That's why surface area of the circular element is equal to length of the circular element, that is called 2 pi r. 2 pi into radius smaller, no? So 2 pi r into width dr. Width means this one, width. Okay, dr. This is the surface area of the element. So mass of the element is this one. So now we know the mass of the element and distance of this central mass of the element from the center. So just you forget this one. The mass of the circular element can be imagined here. Here from the center of the hemispherical shell, this mass dm of the semicircular element, circular element lies at this point, which is at a distance y. In this way, we can imagine number of this type of elements from here. This distance y is equal to 0 to y is equal to capital R. That's why for all the elements you write up, for the all the elements, we can write ycm is equal to y coordinate of central mass is equal to m1y1 plus m2y2 plus and so on by total mass m1 plus m2 plus and so on, we can write. But here, as it is having continuous mass distribution, then for this type of infinite number of elements, the hemispherical shell can be imagined to have infinite number of this type of elements. That's why for infinite number of elements, it's not possible to write all the terms like this. First, for one element, first of all, for one element, you write that mass of that element means mass of the circular element considered here is dm into distance of that element, mass of that element from the center. Mass of the element means as the central mass of the circular element, as the mass of the entire circular element lies here, it is at a distance y. That's why dm into y, right? Dm into y. Plus for another element. In this way, for infinite number of elements, we had right and you had add. Instead of doing so, for one element, you write like this dm into y and you integrate. You integrate. Okay, between the limits, when you consider one element here, theta is equal to 0. When you consider the one element here, theta is equal to 90. From theta is equal to 0 to theta is equal to 90, we can imagine number of elements. Okay, by mass of one element is dm. Sum of mass of all elements means integral dm. So you substitute the dm value. Dm means, you see here, dm means sigma into 2 pi r into dr into y means, from the diagram, y is equal to r cos theta, we can write now. Because y means this one, that is equal to component of this radius along y axis, that is r cos theta. So you write r cos theta. Whole by integral dm is sigma into 2 pi r dr. Okay, so this is equal to, we can write 2 pi sigma into capital R is constant, you write outside. 2 pi sigma into capital R, you write outside. By here also, 2 pi sigma, you write outside. Into integral of, here whenever the number of elements are considered, smaller also changes. If you consider the element here, R will be less. If you consider the element here, R will be maximum, like that. So R is also variable. So integral R dr cos theta, R dr cos theta whole by here R into dr. It is YCM value. It is equal to YCM. Okay, here, what about, here you see, this arc, because it is just like a semicircle. So this arc subtends an angle d theta at the center. That's why length of the arc, but angle subtended by arc at the center. Angle subtended by this width of the semicircular circular element at the center. That is equal to d theta is equal to arc means dr by this distance means radius. dr by Kepler. So from this dr is equal to we can write r into d d theta. No? Substitute here. Therefore, YCM is equal to here you see 2 pi sigma can be cancelled. Then that is equal to r into integral. How we can write r value? How you can write r value in terms of theta? You see, if you take sine theta is equal to small r by Kepler. No? Here sine theta is equal to small r by Kepler. R small r is equal to r sine theta. We can write now. R sine theta we can write. Okay, therefore here you see r can be written as from this formula. Small r can be written as r sine theta into dr can be written as r into d theta into cos theta. Instead of cos theta, you write cos theta only. Whole by integral r means r sine theta. Into dr means r d theta. Okay, so therefore YCM is equal to here r into r, r square you write outside so that r cube it becomes here r square in the denominator. Integral sine theta into cos theta into d theta by sine theta into d theta integral. So that is equal to r cube square cancel. Therefore YCM is equal to r into here this can be written as sine 2 theta by 2, no? Because 2 sine theta cos theta is called sine 2 theta. Or sine theta cos theta is called sine 2 theta by 2 into d theta. Whole by sine theta into d theta. You write 2 outside. Therefore, R by 2 into here sine 2 theta into d theta by integral sine theta into d theta. Limits. As we are doing integration with respect to theta, when you consider the number of elements from this upper part, from this top edge of the hemispherical surface, we can imagine number of elements so that whenever the number of elements increase, the angle increase up to 90 degree, we can imagine. That's why from 0 to here, when you consider the element here, the line joining this element and center lies along this direction only. That's why theta is equal to 0. When you consider the element here, theta is equal to 90. That's why between theta is equal to 0 to 90, we can imagine number of this type of elements. That's why here you integrate between the limits theta is equal to 0 to 90. Theta is equal to 0 degree to 90, pi by 2. Here also 0 to pi by 2. Therefore, YCM is equal to r by 2 into integral sine 2 theta d theta means minus cos 2 theta by 2, no? Because position of theta is 2. Limits 0 to 90 by here. Sin theta means minus cos theta. Limits 0 to theta. Pi by 2. Therefore, YCM is equal to. Here, you write 2 also outside. So, r by 4 you will get. Here, minus cos 2 theta into pi by 2. That means minus cos 2 into pi by 2. 2 to cancel cos pi. Minus cos pi means cos pi minus 1. Minus means plus 1. So, plus 1. Before substituting lower limit, you put minus. So, minus 1 minus plus. Cos 2 into 0. Cos 0. 1. By here also cos theta means pi by 2, cos 90 is 0, you know. Before substituting lower limit, you put minus sign. Minus or minus plus cos 0 means 1. Okay, that is equal to 2 2s are, that means you will get r by 2 now. Therefore, YCM is equal to r by 2. That means in case of hemispherical shell, the center mass lies at a distance equal to half of the radius of the hemispherical shell. That means up to this only center of mass lies. So center of mass lies here only, center of mass at a distance r by 2. Okay, this is the way to find the center distance of the center of mass from the center of the hemispherical shell. Okay, next, in case of solid sphere center of mass lies at the center only. In case of uniform solid sphere means it is having some volume. That's why the solid sphere is having volume density or simply density. In case of solid sphere having uniform mass density, uniform volume density, then the central mass lies at the center only. In case of hemi solid sphere, solid hemisphere, in case of solid hemisphere, in case of solid hemisphere, where the central mass lies. Diagram seems to be like this only. Previous hemispherical shell is there, no? Like that only you'll get. So this is the solid hemisphere of radius capital R. It is y axis, it is x axis. So it is origin. So this distance is equal to radius of the solid hemisphere. Volume density of solid hemisphere is a rho, that is represented with rho. Rho is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. In previous case, in case of hemispherical shell, mass distributes uniformly over the surface only. There is no mass inside the spherical shell. But in case of solid sphere, the mass distributes in entire its volume. No? That's why mass per unit volume, that is the density. That remains constant throughout the volume of the solid hemisphere. Okay, that rho. Therefore, from this mass of the any part of the solid hemisphere is equal to rho into volume of that part we can write now. So here, this solid hemisphere can be imagined as the combination of number of hemispherical shells. Number of hemispherical shells. One such type of hemispherical shell I will imagine. Here I will draw here. Here actually you imagine three-dimensionally. Here this solid hemisphere can be imagined as the combination of, here suppose this is one hemispherical shell, another hemispherical shell, another hemispherical shell. Of course, if you see directly, it is just like a semicircular ring, but it is the solid hemisphere. That's why you imagine hemispherical shell as in previous case. You imagine the hemispherical shell having mass dm and radius. Radius of this hemispherical shell is say small r. Okay, where the central mass of the hemispherical shell lies? Central mass of hemispherical shell lies here, no? That is at a distance say y. What is that y? Central of hemispherical shell y is equal to half of the radius. In case of hemispherical shell, from the center, the central mass of the hemispherical shell lies at a distance equal to radius by 2. For this hemispherical shell, as the radius is r, so y is equal to, we can write r by 2. Mass of this hemispherical shell is dm. How we can write dm in terms of density? Here you see, in case of hemispherical shell, the surface area of the hemispherical shell means, as the thickness of the hemispherical shell is very small, this is very small, dr say, that is dr. Thickness of the hemispherical shell is very small. Dr itself represents very small. That's why almost all inner radius, outer radius, both are same. Inner radius, outer radius, both are same. That's why the surface area of the hemispherical shell is equal to 2 pi r square. No? Surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square. Surface area of the hemispherical shell means 2 pi r square, we can write. So, surface area 2 pi r square into thickness dr, thickness of the hemispherical shell. Hemispherical shell part, mottam thickness dr, kabatti into dr. Surface area into thickness is the volume of the middle of the hemispherical shell. So this gives the volume of the middle of the hemispherical shell. Volume into density. Into density. That is the mass of the hemispherical shell. That is the mass of the hemispherical shell. Okay. So mass of the hemispherical shell is known. And the distance of the central mass of the hemispherical shell from the center O is already known. Therefore, according to the distance of central mass of the solid hemisphere from the center. Here the solid hemisphere can be imagined as the number of, infinite number of combination of this type of hemispherical shells from small r is equal to 0 to small r is equal to capital R. Okay, that's why for one element you write dm into y. Okay, then by integral dm, already previously we have written. For one element, mass of the this hemispherical element into distance of central mass from the center. Okay, then you integrate them by total mass of the entire solid sphere. Total mass means mass of this element is integral dm. Mass of this all the elements means integral dm. So this is equal to, you substitute the data. Integral dm means this one. 2 pi small r square dr into rho by of course, this is only mass into y means r by 2. Y is equal to r by 2. We have by integral dm means 2 pi r square dr into rho. So y is equal to ycm. ycm is equal to here which are constants 2 pi here 2 to cancel. Okay, pi rho are constants. You write outside pi rho into integral of r square into r. That means r cube dr whole by here 2 pi rho. We can take an outside. We can take outside integral r square dr, because whenever you consider the number of elements, radius of each and every hemispherical element changes now. That's why r is the variable. So here pi rho cancel. So 1 by 2 into here. What are the limits? R is equal to 0 to from this center, we can imagine one hemispherical element, zero radius. Up to Kepler radius, we can imagine number of hemispherical elements like this. That's why 0 to Kepler we have to integrate. R is equal to 0 to Kepler. So integral r cube dr means r to power of 4 by 4. Okay, 0 to r by 1 by integral r square means r cube by 3. Limits 0 to Kepler. So this is called 1 by 2 into, when you substitute upper limit, you'll get r to power of 4 by 4. When you substitute lower limit, you get 0 into 3. You can write in the numerator by, instead of r cube, you write r cube. When you substitute 0, it becomes 0. No, here it is small r to power of 4. No, you should not write Kepler directly. Small r first you write. Then when you substitute the limits, you'll get Kepler. These 4 cancel. Okay, therefore, YCM is equal to 3R by 8 you will get now. That means in case of solid hemisphere, the central mass of the solid hemisphere, suppose this is the central mass of the solid hemisphere, then the distance of central mass of the solid hemisphere from the center, that is equal to YCM. YCM is equal to 3R by 8. Okay, in this way we can derive the distance of the central mass from the center of the solid hemisphere. Okay. Next, in case of solid core, where the center of mass lies from the vertex? At what distance center of mass lies from the vertex? Here, we are given just the height of the cone. Height of the cone is given. Suppose you see. This is the solid cone whose vertex is say at origin. It is x-axis, it is y-axis. And solid cone is symmetric about y-axis. That's why definitely Chandra mass lies on line of symmetry. That means along y-axis, at any point somewhere here, Chandra mass lies. X-coordinate of Chandra mass is 0. Here, the height of the cone is small h. That is given. Then where the Chandra mass of the cone lies from the origin, from the vertex? And the vertex which is central mass and the distance lo untundi adi ento calculate cheyali. For that, the solid cone can be imagined as the number of combination of the circular discs. Suppose you cut like this number of slices, then it is one disc. It is one such disc. Of course seems to be rectangular plate, but here it is just like, of course it is one circular disc like this. Actually it is in the form of a circular disc. Okay, it is in the form of a circular disc. Okay, I will draw circular disc only here. Element also in the form of circular disc I will draw. This is one circular element. Whose center is this one, and radius is say smaller. Radius is smaller. Here, no doubt in case of circular disc, center mass lies at the center only. That's why the center mass of this element is at a distance y from the vertex or from the origin. Say, mass of the element is say dm. Mass of the element is say dm. So, what is the density of this solid cone? Because it is a solid cone, it is a three-dimensional object. That's why. That's why the volume density of the cone volume density of the cone, rho is equal to mass of the cone by volume of the cone. Mass of the cone by volume of the cone. So what is the formula for mass by volume of the cone? Mass m by volume of the cone. The cone means 1/3 pi r square h, you know. So we can write like this. Okay, but in general we imagine the volume density is equal to rho. Okay, now if it is the mass per unit volume, then what is the mass of this element considered? Mass of the element is dm. The element is in the form of circular element is in the form of circular disk, no? Suppose if the radius is say r, then the thickness of this element, thickness of the element means that is along this direction. That's why as the distance of central mass of the element from the vertex is y, the thickness is say dy. Thickness is dy. Therefore, area of the disk into thickness dy gives volume. Area of the element means pi r square, because it is in the form of circular disk. That's why pi r square is the area into thickness means dy. That is the volume of the element into density gives mass of the element. Okay. So here we have to write this in terms of y only. Suppose the semi vertex angle is say theta. Semi vertex angle of the cone is say theta. This total angle theta, if it is total angle is theta, this is theta by 2. Or it is the semi vertex angle. And a cone ek vertex dekhra axis, so it is the natural axis of the cone. This y axis acts as the natural axis of the cone. That this cone is symmetric about this natural axis. So the semi vertex angle means half of the angle. That is say theta. Then from the diagram, we had convert this r in terms of dy, r in terms of y. So from this right angle triangle, here you see, this is the right angle triangle. From this right angle triangle, tan theta is equal to r by y, comma tan theta is equal to r by y. R implies r is equal to, we can write y into tan theta. Now we substitute the data. Therefore, the centra mass distance of centra mass of the cone from the bar, from the vertex of the cone, ycm along y axis, it is equal to ycm. Ycm is equal to integral dm into y by integral dm. For everyone we are writing almost all like this one. So ycm is equal to integral dm means mass of the element considered, here this one, pi r square dy into rho, it is mass of the element, elemental disk, into y means y is equal to centra mass lies here at this center. That's why y means distance of the centra mass of the disk from the vertex means that is equal to y only. So you write y only. By integral dm, dm means just you write this one, pi r square dy into rho. Here in this pi is constant, rho is constant, you write outside pi rho into r square y dy, r square y into dy. By here also pi rho is constant, you write outside pi rho, you write outside integral r square into dy. But r is different variable and y is also variable. When you consider number of elements like this, radius of each disk changes and the distance of the center of mass of the element also changes. That's why two variables, we had convert them into one variable. R can be written as y tan theta. Here we substitute, of course, pi rho can be cancelled. You cancel them. Then integral ycm is equal to integral, r means we can write y tan theta, square is there. So y square tan square theta into y dy. Y integral r square means y square tan square theta. Y square tan square theta into dy is there. Here, y square tan square theta can be written outside, no? Because in case of given cone, theta does not change. That's why tan theta remains constant. You write tan square theta outside and we cancel them. Remaining is y square, of course, y square into y cube into dy by integral y square into dy. Y square into dy. So therefore, ycm is equal to this one. As only we are integrating with respect to y, this y value varies. When you consider this element exact at the vertex y is equal to 0 up to this base of the cone, that means this distance is equal to h. That's why y is equal to 0 to h we have to integrate. 0 to h. Y is equal to 0 to h we have to integrate. Therefore, ycm is equal to, when you do integration, then you get y equal to 4 by 4 limits 0 to h by here. Y cube by 3 limits 0 to h. This is equal to, when you substitute the upper limit, then you will get h to the power of 4 by 4. When you substitute lower limit 0 into 1 by, here h cube by 3, By 3 means into 3. When you substitute 2 elements, it becomes 0. So h cube 4 cancel. Therefore, YCM is equal to 3h/4. So from the vertex, the central mass of the cone is at a distance 3/4 of height. Suppose here central mass is there. Here central mass of the cone is there. Then from the vertex, central mass YCM is at a distance of 3h/4. From the base, at what distance central mass lies means, from the base, central mass lies at a distance h/4, no? Because total height is h. Then this height, the central mass of the cone, from the base is equal to h/4, from the vertex is 3h/4. In that way, we can ask. In that way, they may ask. Okay? So in this way, we can find the, we can derive the formula for distance of the central mass of the solid cone. Okay. Similarly, for hollow cone, it is the solid cone. No? Similarly, for hollow cone, just like cone ice cream. When you have the ice cream in the cone, after having ice cream, then the remaining part is the hollow cone. No? In case of hollow cone, the central mass, similarly, like this only, in case of hollow cone, when you imagine number of slices, each slice or each element is in the form of a circular ring, no? The center of mass of the circular ring lies here only. So in that case also, we have to write like this only. So how we can write the mass of the element? In case of hollow cone, the mass of the, this hollow cone is having surface density because mass remains only on the surface, that is a sigma. Then mass of the element dm is equal to surface area of the element, means you see this element is the ring. Surface area means this 2 pi r into this dy. 2 pi r into dy, like this only. 2 pi r into dy is the surface area of the element into sigma. That is the mass of the element. So then by using this formula only, if you do integration between 0 to h, then you will get distance of the central mass from the distance of central mass of the hollow cone from the vertex. Similarly, you can write from vertex YCM is equal to 2h/3. You will get from base. Distance of central mass. Distance of central mass of hollow cone. From base is equal to h/3. So in this way we can do. Okay. Okay, I will derive this also. You see, in case of hollow cone, it is the hollow cone, same diagram, hollow cone, but the mass is distributed uniformly over its surface only. That's why it is having surface density. Surface density means mass per unit area or mass per area, due surface density. That is a sigma. Then you can imagine this hollow cone as the number of circular rings. No? When you divide the number of, when you divide the hollow cone into number of slices, each slice is just like a circular ring. That's why it is the combination of number of circular rings having different radii. Okay, that's why here you can, now you imagine one element here. Mass of that element is a dm, radius of the element is r, which is at a distance y from this one. Because the central mass of this circular element lies at the center only, where the total mass of the ring can be imagined at the central mass here only. Okay, the mass of that element is equal to surface density. Mass is equal to surface density into area. Surface density into area of this element. The length is equal to circumference 2 pi into radius r into width or thickness is equal to dy. 2 pi r into dy. This is the mass of the circular element considered. Okay, therefore, from general formula, YCM is equal to integral dm into y or y into dm by integral dm. This is the general formula. dm is sigma 2 pi r dy. Sigma into 2 pi r dy. Okay. Into y. By integral, dm is sigma into 2 pi r into dy. That's all. This is the YCM value. So we have to simplify that. So YCM is equal to this one. Okay. Of course, sigma 2 pi is constant. You can write outside. That is equal to 2 pi sigma. You take outside. Then integral y into r dy. You write y. Here also 2 pi sigma. You write outside. 2 pi sigma into r into dy. Here 2 pi sigma, 2 pi sigma cancel. So ycm is equal to integral. What about y r dy? R we have to write in terms of y. From the diagram, tan theta is equal to r by y. Just previously how we have written, here also like this only, r by y. In this right angle triangle, tan theta is equal to opposite means r by adjacent means y. So from this r is equal to y tan theta, we can write now. Here r is equal to y tan theta, you write. Y into r means y tan theta into dy by integral r into y tan theta into dy. For the given hollow cone, this vertex angle is constant or semi-vertex angle is constant? Of course, here semi-vertex angle. That's why tan theta remains constant only. No? Tan theta remains constant because r changes linearly with y. That means the r by y ratio remains constant everywhere as theta is constant. That's why you write this tan theta outside. Tan theta into y square dy by integral y into dy by tan theta here. This tan theta will be cancelled. Okay, therefore ycm is equal to integral y square dy by integral y into dy limits. This type of elements can be imagined from this y is equal to 0 to y is equal to h now, because this hollow cone can be imagined as a combination of a number of slices or number of circular elements from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to height of the cone h. That's why between y is equal to 0 to h, you integrate. So that is equal to integral y square dy means y cube by 3, limits 0 to h. By integral y dy means y square by 2, limits 0 to h. Therefore, ycm is equal to, here when you substitute upper limit, you will get h cube by 3. When you substitute lower limit, it becomes 0 into in the denominator. When you substitute upper limit, y h square by 2, you will get by 2 means into 2. Sorry, h square by 2 I wrote. When you substitute lower limit, it becomes 0. Therefore, h square cube cancel. H square cube cancel. Therefore, ycm is equal to, h square cube cancel, not h. Therefore, 2h by 3 you will get. So, the distance of the center of mass from the vertex is equal to 2h by 3. The distance of the center of mass of the hollow cone from the vertex is equal to 2h by 3. From the base, it is at a distance h by 3. Okay. Therefore, it is from vertex. From vertex. From base. From base. Center of mass is at a distance. If it is 2h by 3, this distance is h by 3 only, no? H by 3. That's why distance h by 3. Center mass is at distance h by 3. So this is the answer. You can write like this or like this. Okay, this is the distance of the center mass. In case of hollow cone, the distance of center mass of the hollow cone from the vertex is equal to 2h by 3. Okay, in this way we can derive.